A very good morning to all the first year students. In the previous video of this chapter, bank reconciliation statement, we have discussed that how the differences occurs in the balances of cash book and passbook. Today we will learn the need and importance of the bank reconciliation statement and procedure of preparing it. So first of all, a bank reconciliation statement locates the errors and omissions that may have been committed either on the part of the customer or the bank. Either customer or bank, both can do mistake, but by the BRS we can rectify those mistakes or errors. By preparing a BRS, the customer became sure of correctness of the bank balance shown by the cash book. If we have prepared the bank reconciliation statement, it means and that balance is being tallied now, it means we will be assured that our entries, our cash account bank column is correct. Okay. Now wait for a second. So here you can see third, a reconciliation statement facilitates the preparation of revised cash book. If we have the BRS, we can make our cash book correct. For example, entries relating to bank charges, interest allowed, etc. means all the entries which are completely related to the bank can be done in the cash book too. Okay. Periodic preparation of the statement reduces the chances of embezzlement by the staff of the firm or even that of the bank. If we are preparing BRS, it means that we are becoming sure about our account, and if we are becoming sure, it means that no one can do any type of fraud with us, either a bank employee or a firm employee. Okay. Reconciliation statement helps in revealing the necessary delay in the collection of checks by the bank. If bank is taking much more time in collecting the check, it can be resolved by the BRS. It also helps in keeping a track of checks which have been sent to the bank for collection. Okay, it will be collected, it will be checked, it will be resolved. Okay, now I will tell you the procedure. For preparing the bank reconciliation statement, we have to see that a balance as per cash book may be either debit or credit, and similarly the balance as per passbook may be debit or credit. First of all, we have to look that from where we have to maintain the bank reconciliation statement. It means there are four methods. Let me tell you, there are four methods. First is debit balance as per cash book, means balance as per cash book. Credit balance as per cash book, means overdraft as per cash book. Then debit balance as per passbook, means overdraft as per passbook. And credit balance as per passbook, means balance as per passbook. Okay. Okay, there are many methods of preparing this, but I will tell you the most easy method. And from the upcoming videos, from the next videos, we will discuss the practical questions. We will directly discuss the practical questions. Okay, so till now, read this chapter, and if you find any type of doubts or difficulties in the theory portion, you can ask me, and from the next videos we will discuss the practical questions. Okay.